This was the last photograph taken of the Mercedes before Mr. Paul sped away from the back of the Ritz. By the time he reached the Alma Tunnel, he was hurtling at more than twice the speed limit. He was also entering a notorious accident black spot. Claude Roulet rushed to the tunnel on hearing the news of the crash. There he found the two chauffeurs Dodi had chosen not to use for the journey.
They came to me, they were very nervous. They said, we saw that Monsieur Paul was not in his normal state. Philippe Dourneau even said, il était un peu pompette. It means he was slightly drunk. And we tried to persuade him not to drive, but he didn't want to listen to us.
Jean-Claude Mules of the French Criminal Brigade took charge of the scene of the crash. The French team found the Mercedes had brushed an old white Fiat Uno.
Tout a porté à croire que c'était un accident de la circulation provoqué entre une voiture qui arrivait là, la Mercedes arrivait relativement vite et a percuté cette voiture qui roulait doucement. Le chauffeur a perdu le contrôle de son véhicule, a heurté cette voiture, a commencé à freiner et après il y a eu l'enchaînement automatique de l'accident. Pour nous, l'accident était évident, évident. Et tous les éléments qui sont venus après n'étaient que des allégations. Une allégation en français, c'est un mensonge tant qu'on ne le prouve pas.
The Fiat has never been found. But Mr. Fayed claims it was driven by the photographer James Andanson, who rammed the car on behalf of MI6. When he committed suicide 3 years later, he became a convenient scapegoat. But no witness has ever identified Andanson as the driver. His widow testified that he was at home with her on that night. His road tolls and credit card receipts confirm this.
J'ai entendu Andanson. L'alibi qu'il a donné était parfaitement vérifié. La Fiat a été contrôlée par la gendarmerie. Ce n'était pas la bonne Fiat que nous recherchions. Il était hors de cause. On ne l'a pas gardé. Hein?
So what of the claim that Henri Paul was deliberately blinded by a bright flash? Papparazzi were first on the scene, using flash photography to take these pictures. But only petty criminal François Lavistre has ever claimed a flash and the crash happened at the same time. His own wife, also in the car, has refused to confirm his story. The jury did not believe him. It took 1 hour, 43 minutes for Diana to get to hospital. Medics also working for MI6. Diana's blood pressure was so low that to move her quicker would have killed her. At one point, she had no pulse. And the French used fully equipped ambulances to treat patients at the scene. The fact she made it to hospital alive was a tribute to her medical care. Only there did she suffer a further fatal heart attack. One by one, the methods of murder claimed by Mr. Fayed were fading away. How would the motives for her killing stand up in court? At the coroner's inquest, Mohamed Fayed claimed Diana and Dodi were engaged to be married, and that Dodi had given Diana a ring. He says they told him this personally in a phone conversation only an hour before their deaths. It's a claim dismissed by Diana's friends. Rosa Monckton was one of her closest.
First, I know she would have picked up the telephone to me because we talked so much just 10 days before. She would have told her son, she would have told her sister. You know, she wouldn't have just kept it a secret, and she wouldn't have been looking quite as sour-faced as she was looking in those awful last pictures that one saw of her. She thought that she needed somebody there the whole time. In Dodi, for the first time, there was somebody who could be there the whole time, and she was beginning to be quite irritated by that. And she said to me, you know, he's trying to buy me. Keeps giving me presents, so many presents. And she said, and I know he's going to give me a ring. And I tell you, it is firmly going on the finger on my right hand, the finger on my right hand. She was very clear about the fact that he was going to do that and what she was going to do with it.
At the inquest, the only person to back up Mr. Fayed's claims of an engagement ring was jeweller Alberto Raposo. When I first interviewed Alberto Raposi 6 months after the crash, he told me he had no idea what the ring meant. He told me that Dodi had come alone into his shop on their last afternoon and that he was very disappointed that he never met Princess Diana. Imagine my surprise 5 years later when I read an article in Paris Match by Alberto Raposi in which he says, the day that Diana and Dodi announced their engagements to me. He says that he met the couple in a hotel in Saint-Tropez and placed a ring on Diana's engagement finger. At the inquest, Alberto Raposi was confronted with his own CCTV images. They showed Dodi Fayed leaving his shop with only a catalogue. And no evidence was produced to the jury that Diana herself ever saw the ring.
It's a view shared by the man who looked at the rings with Dodi, Claude Roulet.
Was the word engagement ever mentioned in this meeting by anybody, particularly Dodi?
No, never.
In no moment
Dodi spoke wedding or engagement.
Only after Dodi had left the shop, the so-called engagement ring was produced by Madame Raposi.
She said it's something very new. It's a new collection, which is called Dis-moi oui. Tell me yes. And I took everything with me back to the hotel. Finally, Dodi came out. He took the box, put the box on the little table. And then I said, you will give it tonight? But I don't know, maybe tonight or tomorrow, I don't know.